Okay, so I'm ready. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
I think. Yeah, I'm ready. Let's do this.
When did you know you wanted to propose?
I knew I wanted to propose essentially around December when I was actually picking out, when we started talking about the ring and the diamond. I kind of knew, I started plotting my idea in December.
I'm as happy as I can be, 'cause I'm allergic to tragedy. The doctor said something's wrong with me. The smile on my face has no remedy. So baby, don't say no. Come on and just say yes. You know it's time to keep it simple. Let's take a chance and hope for the best. Life is short, so make it what you want.
The idea that I came up with this video, it took me actually a long time to figure it out. I searched through, I don't know, hundreds of YouTube videos, and I narrowed down a couple that really touched my heart, and I thought that would touch your heart. It's a collaboration of those, so it's my own little thing.
Girl, I've been thinking about us, and you know I ain't good at this stuff. These feelings piling up won't give me no rest. Yeah, a little sideways, yeah, maybe. I don't know how long it'll take me, but I'll do my best. You'll be my soft and sweet, I'll be your strong and steady. You'll be my glass of wine, I'll be your shot of whiskey. You'll be my sunny day, I'll be your shade.
Preparing this video was insanely tough because, you know, you know everything about me, you know when I'm nervous, you know I can't really lie to you, you have access to all my money, all my emails, you know everything about me. I wish, you know, and I guess like that's one of the things I'm going to be striving for in this next chapter, is learning everything about you. I know it's only, I feel like so little, and I know a lot, but I feel like there's so much to explore and learn about you, and that's what, you know, I'm really excited for.
Do you hear me talking to you across the water, across the deep blue ocean, under the open sky? Oh my baby, I'm trying.
Boy, I hear you in my dreams, I feel you whisper across the sea, I keep you with me in my heart. You make it easier when life gets hard. Lucky I'm in love with my best friend. Lucky to have been where I have been. Lucky to be coming home again. Lucky we're in love in every way. Lucky to have stayed, though we have stayed. Lucky to be coming home someday.
actually, that was that song came out actually around the same time that we kind of got together. And actually, the first time you ever picked me up, that song was blaring in your car. And I just remember that.
Tell her every day. Yeah, I know. When I compliment her, she won't believe me. And it's so sad to think that she don't see what I see. But every time she asks me, do I look okay? I say, when I see your face, there's not a
while I was creating this video, it took a while to get everyone to get all the videos to me. And then since you have all access to everything, it's hard to like hide from you for such a long period. You know, we were supposed to do everything actually in October. And I initially did it in August to get everything kind of ready. But the longer it stretched out, the more you caught on to things. And I know you did catch on to it because you know, on my phone you had to like save space on my phone for me, and I know I left one of the videos on there. And you kind of told me that, you know, what are you up to? So that led me to throw you off and do the sunset proposal at St. Pete Beach, and so you wouldn't know about this grand. This is the big proposal. This is what I really wanted intended for you, and the other one was kind of like, I had to throw you off the trail. That was definitely a big challenge too, but this was really what I wanted to show you.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. I give you all of me.
and you give me all of you. Oh. I think I met Tia when I was in 10th grade, and that was probably 14 years ago, I think. But I mean, even before we met, I knew who she was, and she's seen me before because I ran through her backyard a couple times and she gave me this like WTF look.
I have known Tia since 2 years ago when we started our public health masters. And since then, she has invited me into her life, and it has always felt that we knew each other for a really long time.
Hey, Tia and Zhang. I've known Tia for 10 years now. No, wait, 12 years since we were 15, 16. It's crazy how fast time flies. Well, that's how you know it's a true friendship, when your friendship just lasts through thick and thin.
But anyways, our brothers were best friends back then in high school, so kind of knew who she was. And we became friends when Tia started her little Asian club or whatever that was. And she needed people to join and to participate in doing dances and stuff. So that was how we met. And how long ago? It's freaking almost half my life now. Tia, damn.
Since sophomore year of high school, it's about 13 years.
I have known Tia for a very long time. I met her when I was in high school. We met on the tennis courts at Firefighters Park.
So the word that I think of when I think of Tia is energetic. She always has so much energy in every aspect of her life. She's always ready to go dancing. She's always ready to plan another trip to a new city. And I always think of her as a ball of energy.
Tia is such an awesome person, and she has so many great qualities. But if I had to narrow it down to just one word to describe her, I would say she's very caring. That's how she earned the nickname of Mama Tia.
A lot of words that come to my mind when it comes to Tia, but I think for me it'd be inspirational. In the way she touches everybody, in the way that she touches me and makes me and inspires me to be a better person.
I think the first word that comes to my mind when thinking of Tia is the word caring. She is probably one of the most caring people that I know in this world. And you know, every time we go on trips or we're going out, Tia will always be the one planning, setting up the itinerary for us, and just making sure that, you know, everything's set. And you know, we never have to worry about anything when we go out with her.
The one word that comes to mind when I think of her, amazing, dependable, trustworthy, patience, is how I would describe her as well. She is just such a dependable and loving person, has so much to give to the people around her. And if you ever need anything, she is that type of person that's always there, no matter what.
She's always looking out for everyone, and she always remembers what everyone wants and thinks about everybody. It's quite impressive. I try to be half like her, and I failed. So, thank you for still being my friend.
I would describe Tia's personality as very charismatic, very caring, very warm to her friends and to her family. And I also think of her as very savvy, very smart and intelligent in everything that she does.
I think Tia's personality is that she's very outgoing, she's very friendly, people person, everyone loves her all the time. But, you know, besides that, she's also very honest and very straightforward, and, you know, she tells you just how it is.
Tia is very, very caring and organized and smart, wise, and just very bubbly. Everyone likes being around her. She makes friends easily, she's fun to be around, she's funny, cute, and always a happy face. And we love going on trips with her because she's so organized and good at deal hunting. She's a awesome bargain shopper. We're lucky to have her.
I can always go to her for advice, and she would just tell me exactly what she thinks of it. And I really respect that, so thank you very much, Tia.
Oh, if I were to describe Tia's personality, it would be bubbly. In that, yeah, she's constantly, she always surprised me all the time. She's like really happy all the time. She's really motivational, really positive, constantly.
And I would say she's very, very wise. I always turn to her for all my problems, and she always gives me the best advice, wisdom. She just knows what's up. She's very thoughtful and a deep person. She's smart. So I think she's very lucky, whichever guy marries her, and now I know who that guy is. Very lucky guy. And yeah, she's just such a joy to bring to everyone, an inspiration.
The best and funniest memory with Tia, too many from the trips that we've taken. The screaming and running through airport terminals to catch our flights, the heater fiasco in Atlanta, and all our alcohol-induced memories. we've had really great memories that I've always cherished, and I'll always cherish.
The funniest memory that I have with Tia is probably when we started studying at Starbucks, and then it became later on a drinking party in downtown Gainesville, and we went from studying to drinking beers to stealing some popcorn and then going dancing. And it was such a great night full of laughs and mischievous happenings that I always have that in my heart.
My best memory with Tia has to be how I met her. This is actually when we were only 15. I stalked her for about a week. I thought there was this really cute girl walking in front of me, same path, going home from school every single day. Stalked her for a week before I finally worked up the courage and sweat to go up to her and say, "Hey Tia," at the time I didn't know her name yet. "Hey, can I walk with you guys home? Because we're walking down the same path." And she looked me up and down like, "You? Okay, fine, let's go." And so we started walking home together from school, and that's how we became friends. She was actually walking with this other girl, and I don't even remember her name anymore, but poor girl, I guess the two of us became friends, but we ditched the other girl eventually. But how we really solidified our friendship was not only that I stalked her and hit on her, was also that she had recruited me for her Asian dance team, and she had no idea whether I could dance or not. In fact, I was a terrible, terrible dancer. The only reason why she recruited me is because I look Asian. So clearly the bar was low and I met it.
I think my favorite moments with Tia was back in high school when we were still neighbors in Woodlands. She would be walking around the neighborhood, and I'll be riding my bike, and I'll just run up next to her. Oh, by the way, she was running, and we would just chat, and then I would ask her for advice, and she would always give me these great pointers and stuff like that. And I really enjoyed the simple times back then that we had. Sometimes we would run over to Belle's place, and it's just what we did back then, and it's sad that we can't do it anymore, but it was a lot of fun.
So I started going to her dance practices at our house on Saturday afternoons, and then eventually doing dance performances with her at weddings, at shows, and some of them we even got paid for. I was like, wow, this girl knows what's up. Like, she's so good at organizing, bringing everyone together, choreographing, designing the costume. She's just done a lot of work. She's very, very talented. And through our dance experiences, we started also hanging out and going out, having fun, doing all kinds of stuff. And that's how we became friends.
Advice that I would give to you. I don't really think I am the good person to give this advice to, but I would have to say, just remember why you two fell in love to begin with. There's gonna be good and bad times along the way. But you two go well with each other, and I think you should always remember why you fell in love with each other originally.
my advice for Tia in her new adventure is that to ground herself in the simple things and ground her family in simple things, and not to get too distracted with life, and always work towards your own truth and know what makes you happy and what deserves your time and energy.
The advice I would give Tia as she embarks on this new chapter in her life, to be patient and forgiving, babe. You're already all those things, and I know you're going to be a great wife. I'm super happy for you too.
If I have to give Tia any advice, it would be to please remember, never change. I really, really love you for the way you are. And marriage is not really the end of a relationship. It's actually just the beginning of a new chapter in your life. You're going to go overcome even more challenges, and there will be a lot of happy moments too, of course. But life doesn't just get easy automatically. You have to work at it, and there will be some times when things don't go right. Please stay positive like you always had. Don't ever change. Remember who you were. Stay the same. And remember, I'm always here for you, no matter what. You're family to me. Just remember that. I love you.
Tia, you're about to start the next chapter of your life, and I'm so happy for you. I'm not sure what kind of advice I can give you, because you're the one that always gives me advice. But if I have to give you one, I would say to just keep being you. You know, you're an amazing person, and we all love you for that. And just don't change anything about yourself. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy life. Enjoy, you know, engagement. And then hopefully I will see you soon, and we can all celebrate this.
The thing I'm most excited for is that we're starting a whole brand new, like, chapter of our lives, kind of away from our parents, just kind of me and you tackling the world, and I think that's really, like, what, I don't know, kind of feel like that's, that's what I've always needed, and I've kind of always wanted, but I always couldn't, it was hard for me to do it. And now I have somebody to do it with, and it's really crazy exciting. So.